You say, why is there no backrest? You said, KImmerle, why is there no backrest? There's no backrest because I want your lower back engaged. You'll notice that a lot of guys will arch their butt away from the seat. So by the time they're done, the only thing touching the bench is like the top of their back, and their butt is a good foot and a half flat that way. Well, that's basically an incline press. That's all front delts. I want to engage the back as well. So to do that, as you prop these up on your shoulders and go ahead. Okay. Now I want you to engage your back as you're pressing up. Eight sets of eight. Go. One. Two. Those arms straighten. Four. Five. Lean forward. Six. Harder. Seven. Eight. Drop them. Okay, let's talk. When I say lean forward and you don't lean forward, what are you thinking?
I thought I did lean forward.
No. What you're doing is exactly what I was talking about. Most guys like to bend, like to do shoulder presses like this. Okay? My back is like my whole body is on an angle. I want you almost leaning forward and then pressing.
And how was I starting?
You were here. And the weights were ending up out here.
Really?
Because it was easier. If those were 50-pound dumbbells, they'd never get them out there.
It can't be good for your shoulder.
Huh?
It can't be good for your shoulder.
It's not bad for your shoulder, because I mean, I've got you doing raises. The idea is it's just not the exercise intended, okay? So I want you, remember the bowl of soup in the back? That's what I'm going for here. I want you to feel that pain in your lower back, okay? So I've got this, it's almost like it's cramping. And then as I press those over my head, my entire back, all of this has to engage as well as the shoulders. Let's go. Now lean hard, hard forward. Yeah. One, two, three. All right, four. I'm gonna do something to you. Five, six. Now get him up. Seven, that's shoulders. Eight, drop him. Okay, what you didn't see there is a knee in the back. That knee prevented his back from shooting toward me. Just like the abs, as soon as your butt starts to shoot behind you, then it literally kills that sticking point. And right now, I didn't allow him to avoid the sticking point, and you saw his rep just stop. Okay, I'm gonna make this muscle do the work, or the weights aren't gonna go up. So I'm gonna put my knee in his back again. He's gonna do eight more, and he's gonna struggle, and I'm gonna spot him because that's what a good trainer does. And then when he does this on his own, you're gonna be probably with 20 pounds. But you're gonna make sure that bowl of soup that you started with stays there, okay? And you were still doing a good job, but you kept the bowl of soup and your body was still coming back this way. I want you to err on the side of leaning forward. Now, you'll know what I'm talking about because all this will just engage. You'll feel it the first time you do it. Okay, bowl of soup. Oh! Give me some shoulders, I want apples. One, two, three, four. Straighten those arms. Five, six, seven, come on, eight. Yes, you're the man. Awesome. Now, trick. You know you're gonna be doing eight sets of this, right? And you now know you're three sets into it. When you're done with these, and usually you're sitting in the mirror, I want you to set them right here, pop one shoulder back, pop the other shoulder back, and look in the mirror, and watch that sweat drip off your forehead. And turn into a badass. You're transforming, you're willing apples to the side of your arms. Boom, shoulders. Boom, arching the back. Boom, straight up and down. Boom, back down. As soon as I'm done with my eight, I look in the mirror, I don't drop them. My job is to hold these weights. And I know that I'm gonna take a longer than a 20 second rest if I drop them. I just gave you a 30 second rest, let's go. Train it inspired. Two, three. Why are you leaning so back into me? Four, lean forward. Five, lean forward. Six, lean forward. Seven, up, up, up. Eight is here, it's not out here. On your knees, good job. Okay, you feel that difference? Good job, man. Wait, 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 wait. Leave them on your knees. You're not going anywhere. You have 10 seconds. You have to lift him back up again. Okay? Now that heart rate is not impressing me. Okay? Fight. I want you to fight. See this arch in your back? I want you to make it go the other way, and we go right now. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Up. Up. Fight. Eight. Drop him. Okay, do me a favor.
I didn't see that I was going.
Yeah, why?
Compensating? My muscle's compensating?
It's totally avoiding the work. I mean, if this is straight and I'm going against gravity, then anything that's not gravity is easier, right? Even if it's for a second. I could easily punch that weight out here and bring it back. So I avoided it, right? So that's what you're doing is that last little bit, you're just popping forward, which allows you to straighten your arm and you're coming back down. Or it makes you feel like you straightened out. Okay? Well, I gotta be honest. With my knee in your back, you did a couple of them right, but every one of those reps were wrong. And this is 25 pounds. And to start the conversation, I said, hey, what do you usually press with? Because I'm gonna drop a little bit for the 8 sets of 8, and you said 30s to 40s. And I guarantee those weren't right.
What about the benches up? Does that make it any better?
No, if you can't do these that way, then there's no way you're doing the other ones right. Okay? And if these are harder, what do we always do? The hardest. Have a seat. You're not straining your back. You're working it. Okay, I'm gonna stick my. Now I want you to lean back. Yeah. One. Lean forward now. Two. Three. Four. Five. Now wait, what are you thinking when you drop it and your arms didn't extend? Extend them. There you go. Come on, now this is my job. Six, up, seven, up, 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 eight. Good job. You have two more. Yeah. How come you keep standing up? You don't need water. He thinks he needs some water. He doesn't need water, he needs a rest. You don't need water, you need a rest. If you're one of those people that takes a water bottle with you everywhere you go, you're killing me. You're absolutely killing me. You're more worried about your water in this 1 hour of the day. How much water do you carry around the rest of your day, honestly? I love you. Now, that's different. He got himself a pep drink. That's different than water. Now, if you're sipping on an intra-supplement workout drink, great. If you're getting some aminos, some beta-alanine, some of the bells and whistles during your training, let's go, buddy. Whew. So much pressure on me, you're gonna fall down. Lean forward, lean forward, lean forward, lean forward. Okay, I got you. One.
Three.
Nope, you didn't do one of them right. Two. Three. Four. Remember this pain. Five. Come on. How bad does this hurt? Six. Tell me. Seven. One more. Eight. Hold. 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 Why am I holding these here? Hold. Drop them. You're doing so good, dude. You're doing so good. Okay, you are. You found your second wind. You're pushing through. You're doing something that's excruciatingly painful. This morning I was taking cycling and a little girl handed me pink weights. They are 2 pounds a piece and made me put them over my head for 2 minutes. I thought I was gonna die. Here I am in the gym 2 nights ago with 100 pound dumbbells above my head thinking I'm all badass and I can't even hold 2 pounds above my head for 2 minutes. So we're strong in different ways. Okay, I'm making you strong in this way and you probably kick my butt on the tennis court in some other weird way. You know what I mean? It's just the different skills we've earned through our life. You're earning this one right now, okay? Okay, we're gonna call this your last set. One, two, three, four, come on, five, come on, six, come on, seven, come on, eight. Ooh, going for nine, drop it. That's it. Tell me how you feel. Tell me how you feel. Tell me how you feel. Tell me.
Okay, not bad. Not bad. 113.
All right. Find the eye of the tiger. Find it. Find it in you. All right, you ready for this one? This is gonna be a row. Put my hand here, I put it in front. I don't care if you make a fist. Sometimes I just like to make a fist because I feel like it's making my just everything stronger. And I'll flex my shoulder. Everything from here is locked. Kick that leg back. Now I put a bowl of soup in my back. My back's parallel to the ground. And I bring my elbow up. And I take it all the way back down. Another alteration is to move. I personally don't like doing that. I like staying right here with my arm all the way extended. Bring it up. Try to clear my back with my elbow. Okay? In other words, could I stick a broomstick across my back and through my elbow? As long as I clear that plane, I know that my back is all the way engaged. So, I would start. Boom, 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 boom. One, two, three. A mistake a lot of people make is they go, four. Well, what did I just do? I cheated. If my back is not parallel with the ground from all directions, then I lose that leverage. Okay? Go ahead. Eight sets of eight means eight, one arm, immediately switch over and do eight. That's one set.
My head is facing anywhere?
Your head is facing that way, directly ahead. Head on backwards, grr. Come on, one, two, perfect. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Put the weight on the bench, switch hands, immediately go. Perfect transition. One, two, bowl of soup, three, bowl of soup, four, five, give me a bowl of soup here, six, seven, eight, drop it. Okay, now from right here, give me a bowl of soup in my back. See this? I want that to go away. Look, you're going from hunchback to bowl of soup. Yeah, there we go. See how you sat into it and the shoulder came this way? That allows you to create more of a bend here, right? Now bring the shoulder this way. Now make that go down. Why won't that go down? See this? That's straight. I want it to dip. I want you to stick your ass in the air. And I want you to feel pain right here. Do you feel that? Okay, we're gonna work on your flexibility. But that has got to become a bowl of soup. Right now, your lower back, you're saying it's hurting you all the time? Yeah. Or at least it's a secondary muscle to most of the things we're working. It's because I got to have you have better manipulation of your lower back.
Yeah.
Let's switch that over.
So what is that? Why is that? Why don't I?
You just don't have any flexibility. It's the same reason why I don't have any hip flexors. Just throughout life, I've done enough things to where I can't bend over as well as, or as flexible as somebody else. But you'll earn it. You didn't even know you didn't have it. Okay. See, your back is still on an angle a little bit. So that means that front arm needs to shoot forward. And I need you to come up on that knee. Yeah. Take that knee so it's straight up and down from your body. See how this is shooting forward?
Yep.
I want it back. Yep, right there. Now give me a bowl of soup. Okay, now do them. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Switch sides. Transition's quick and fast. Perfect placement of the knee. It's perpendicular to the floor. Stuck your butt out, arched your back. Beautiful. Three, four, five, six, seven. Put that weight back on the bench. Eight. All right, switch arms again. We're gonna go away from our 20-second rest. Okay, we're gonna manipulate our 20-second rest. Our heart rate's at 108. We're gonna get it up. One, faster, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Switch arms. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8. See what you're doing? You started to sit back on it. As you sit down like a baby, it takes away from the work. This hand. You were here instead of here. Here instead of here. From right here, my foot is actually, it's not perpendicular. It's even overcorrected. So right about here is perpendicular. Now, if I know that this leg has to be perpendicular to the floor, how do I then put my hands? That's really what trumps it. Boom. See, I've got that really right here. Hurts my spinal erectors. I'm flexing them so hard, they're ready to cramp. Crack. So instead of being here, because that is easier, you want to be here. You'd think that moving your body 1 to 6 inches would make a difference. It does. Let's go.
If I start off wrong, or should I start
you did
right?
This side right and that side wrong. One, two, three, four, five. Get that elbow up. 6, 7, 8. Good job. Perfect. 1, 2. Great job. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, rack it again. Do it again. Now this, I want you to concentrate on keeping this back flat. 2, 3, 4. And the further the weight goes that way, the harder it is. 5, 6, 7, 8. Feel that? Yeah. As soon as you, all I did was move the weight that way. I moved it closer to your leg. See, what you're doing is a lot of bicep, where you can bring it up, and I'm engaging a shiz ton of bicep rather than bringing it out here. Then the only way to get it up is for my elbow to shoot toward the ceiling rather than this, right? Go ahead. You like all these rests I'm giving you? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good job. Nice. Huh, you're 5 sets into it. 3 more.
Use gloves?
Huh?
Use gloves?
I use Versa grips.
Everything?
Yeah.
So you don't have calluses?
Oh, I have calluses. But I like them.
Me too. I think they're like...
Yeah, man hands. I wouldn't have it any other way, to be honest with you. I mean, I do own a pet egg, just, you know, for the chance that I might need my hands a little softer, but... yeah, for the most part, I don't need them soft, so I let them go like that. Plus, you get on set, and they don't let you use them, right? So you'll be grabbing a bar, and if you don't have that strength, your hands will bleed. Like I've been on set with brand new diamond plate bars, and halfway into the day, my hands are just bleeding. Let's go. Okay, on this one, we're gonna be fun. We're gonna finish up his reps total. He's in a hurry, we gotta get out of here. So he's gonna go ahead and do 24 on this arm. 6, 7, 8. See this elbow needs to come up higher. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I want you to push the weight back here as far as you can. 14, 15, 16, 17. Get that weight back here. 18, 19. Get that elbow up. 20, 21. Think about it. 22. Think about it. 23. Why are you here? 24. All right. Good job. Now, eventually, you'll bring that weight up and kick it back at the same time on your own. Yeah. You can't make me happier with a face like that, my friend. Yep. Yes. All right. Let's finish up. 24. One, two, three, four. Straighten that arm. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. See these shoulders? 11. I want them to come forward. These got to be parallel with each other. Now bring it up. 2, 14. The shoulder has got to go forward, 15. Toward the camera, 16, 17, 18. Don't ignore me, 19. It gets harder, doesn't it? 20, 21, 22, 23, that's all bicep, 24. Good job. Yes. Now you're gonna watch this video and you're gonna see exactly what I'm talking about the bicep. Now your heart rate's what? Well, yeah, we got it up to 122, okay? The reason why it's not higher is because the massive piece of meat wasn't doing the work the little one was, okay? The weight was coming up either way. Now what I could have done is raised that weight up to 60s and got your heart rate up, but I'm trying to really, really isolate that movement right there with that big muscle group. Good job, buddy. That's a minute rest. Now we're gonna go into 8 sets of 8, bicep curl. 1, 2, the arms have to straighten. 3, let me show you a trick. See where you grabbed on the dumbbell? Mm-hmm. Grab all the way down. What this does is allows you to get you closer to your hip, allowing you to keep your elbows closer to your hip, okay? And you're gonna start right here. So start with perfect form. Now, nothing moves, none of this moves, the weights come up. 3, 4, straighten the arms. 4, 5, kick the elbows forward. 6, keep them forward. 7, 8, drop them. Okay, what happens the second I push the elbows forward? Okay, now, no, it got harder, yes. Okay, every time I ever do biceps, you'll see my hand, I just automatically grab to the inside of the dumbbell. Now, one of the cheats that I like personally is I like to roll my shoulders forward and kick my elbow into my side. Okay?
Yeah,
now,
I do.
Now, if you see that, my elbow's actually resting against my belly. Now it can't move. That's not me cheating, it's me ensuring the fact that my bicep's gonna do the work. 1, 2. Now, I hate it when guys do this to me. I'm not 15 sets of 8x8s into this, right? That's your 20-second rest. Let's redo these.
What are those things called? Those Arnold used to use this.
Oh, the arm blasters. Hell yes, you're using your chest as an arm blaster. Great, great reference. Okay, see this elbow, how it's on the side? I described it actually pressing against my belly. Okay, a lot of you guys are gonna make the same mistake. Don't make it. This elbow is still not in your belly. There it is. Straighten those arms. 6, 7, 8. Okay, we're gonna drop your weight. Now, we asked him what his weights were. Hey buddy, what do you usually bicep curl with? 25s to 35s. Well, I guarantee he's not doing more or less than sets of 8 when he's doing these. So right now I just asked him to use 25s because we're gonna do 8 sets of 8, dropping his weight, and he was unable to do 16 perfectly, which means the weight he's been training with is too heavy. Fair enough? So we're gonna start you off with a little bit less weight. And now we're grabbing the weight. All right, you're gonna have to fight for these ones, buddy. Let's go. You're the man, the master plan. We're 1, 2, love it. See the angle of the weights? 3. He's actually using the outside of the weight to supinate his hand, his palm, to create the ball. Perfect. Oh. Beautiful.
What about like going as high?
Drop them. You're going plenty high enough. Because if you went any higher, that's a great question. If you went any higher, this is my theory. This is how I've trained my biceps. From here to here is great. Right here, you lose all your leverage. So nothing's really happening here except for a contraction. Well, you can get that on your own. So I say train the bottom. Okay, this is it. And if you come all the way up here, you have to move your elbow. So it's here to here. And then later on in the day, we'll train the top of the bicep, which means creating leverage. As soon as I drop down from here to here, See that elbow shooting away from my body? Now when I go like this, it's all leverage. Okay.
So let me ask you, we discussed this last time, but the distance between my muscle and my elbow.
Yep.
Is that a genetic thing? Is that
Yes, of course it is. The distance between here is usually non-existent because people don't straighten their arms when they curl. So the bicep can only be built from here to here because that's where you're straightening your arm to. If your arm's here, which it usually is, and you stop right here, and then you go back up, then you've gone back down, that's straight. Most people don't train that way. They train to here or to here. That's straight. That is not straight. There's an inch difference. That's the difference here. Let's go. Nope, you have no genetic predisposition that should prevent you from having fantastic arms. One. Two. Thank you for moving the elbow, good man. Four. Six. Now you say, KImmerle, what do I do so the weights don't hit my legs when I want to straighten my arms? Go up. Back down. Guaranteed to straighten your arms just by leaning back. Good job. It's three.
Pain in my elbow.
Pain in your elbow? Discomfort in your elbow or pain?
Discomfort.
Par for the course. I've trained my biceps so much, I swear to God, I almost went to the hospital 2 days later. I was like, I cannot straighten my arm. I thought I'd injured it. It was well beyond hurt. I was well beyond being proud of myself for ripping apart my muscle tissue. I thought I'd injured something. Nope. It just hurt so bad that I'd literally not injured myself, but I'd reached a new pain threshold. So every once in a while, and for all you guys listening right now, you will train your biceps to where this area right here hurts. For some reason, oh my God, it hurts. For you beginner bicep guys, you 18-year-olds, the wrists are what hurts. You'd be on the preacher curl machine and all of a sudden your wrists are just killing you. It goes away. Okay, I promise, go. Oh, it's a burn. I got burned.
Sounds like a story.
It's a pretty good story. Elbows in. Fight for your life. One. Two. Three. Love the twisted arms. Four. Five. I literally do mine like this. Six. Seven. Eight. I know that burns. Drop them. Okay, have two more sets of this.
Now, we're going to stretch this out. What do you recommend?
Straight out and down. Yep. Take off my shirt here. So, your bicep faces toward the ceiling. Okay? So, this is my straight up. I know my bicep's straight up, right? Then I turn my wrist without my bicep moving. Yep. I like to, and then I'm trying to break my wrist down. Breaking it down, break it. I'm trying to hyperextend my whole arm. Now, one of the things I like to do, this exact position, is grab a weight. This is heavy. Do not do this at home. I do this with 10 pounds, but I have a 17 here, so that's what I'm gonna use. Now, I close my eyes, and I wait for my arm to break. I know it's not gonna break. So what does that mean? I'm getting the best stretch in history in my bicep. It does not work like this. My bicep is faced the ground. Oh, now it's faced the camera. Oh, now it's almost there. Oh, now we're doing it right. But my wrist is gonna break that way. I have to be able to move my wrist. So I'm pushing my bicep as far that way, and then this weight will come down, stretching the living crap out of your bicep. Good job, man. Or you got this post here, right? Same thing. Just pop up against the post and lean into it. The arm has to be straight. The bicep has to be facing the wall. One, two, three, four. Bring those up a little bit higher. Five, higher. Six, seven, higher. Eight, good job. Yeah. Now if you can, on the next two sets, I want you to slow it down. This is your speed right now. You've got it all the way supinated, I love it. Your arms all the way to the side. Digging the elbow in. This is your speed. I want to be one, two, down. One, two, down. Dare this 17-pound weight to mess with me. Down. Dare my boss to look at me funny again. Down. Dare my daughter to go on another date without telling me. Down. Dare my arm to not grow. Down. Any affirmation you come up with, whether it be positive or negative, come up with it.
How much bigger can you or do you want
to
get?
I can't get any bigger.
That's it. I know that.
Well, I can get bigger.
But yeah.
I'm going to grow myself right out of a job. So I'm just trying to get dense.
All right,
gotcha. Let's go. Okay, the last set, we're going to knock out 16 because you're a badass. One, two, down. One, two, down. Yes. Now we're talking. That's training biceps right there. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Switch to hammer curl. It's right here. One, two, down. Don't move those wrists. Just come straight up. Nope. Here. Three. Four. Up. Five. Up. Six. Up. Seven. Up. Stop letting them rest on your area. Up. Eight. Good job. Set him down. Okay. We moved him up on his 16 because he's got to hurry. So you learned eight sets of eight. There is absolutely no misunderstanding about it. You do eight sets. You do eight reps. Then you're going to do it for eight sets and you're going to take a 20-second rest in between, sometimes 30. Then you're going to take a minute rest while you're switching exercises and then duplicate that same equation. Do eight reps, rest 20, 30 seconds, do eight more till you've done that eight times. Very, very basic equation. Now you get in a hurry, say you couldn't find your dumbbells or you just ran out of time, somebody called you and now you got to leave the gym early, whatever the heck happened, you shouldn't have your phone in with you anyway because that will happen. But if it does, go ahead and do what we just did, which is finish your reps, just get it done, fight through it. He just did 16 straight. I made him switch positions. You're much stronger in hammer curl position, which is why he did it that way. Abs. Right now we're gonna do chest. Okay, he's gonna do eight sets of eight with chest. I asked him how many push-ups can you do in a row? He says usually between 15 and 20. That's what he knocks out on his own. Right now he's gonna do 64, okay? But he gets to do them in increments of eight. Let's go. Show me a perfect push-up. The push-up for all push-ups. One, two, three, four. Look forward. Five, six, seven, eight. Rest. 17, 15, 14. I like it. Stretch. Give a good stretch. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, rest. Now you're gonna watch him deplete. You're gonna watch these first couple reps, he's gonna get right through them, he's gonna knock them out, but eventually, we're gonna get 4, 6, 7 sets into it. Now he's done 56 push-ups. He's gonna be hurting, okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, right about now, you better remember why you came here. 2, 3, get that ass in the air. 4, 5, get that ass in the air. 6, 7, 8, good job, okay. The further you stick up your butt, the harder it gets, doesn't it? But we make sure we stick our butt up all the time. If you're just trying to touch a pecker on the ground, and I'm wording that just because it's the easiest reference, if your hips are touching before your chest and your body's on that angle, that's wrong, okay? So you can almost err on the side of sticking your butt up, then going down. Or you can be here. But it's not this. Now, if you're gonna do those, arch your back hard and do a decline. Okay? All right, let's get into it. One, two, three, four, five. Lead with that chest, six, seven, eight. Okay, good job. Now the next ones, don't move. You're gonna be here in 15 more seconds. The next ones, I want your chest to touch and your butt not to. Okay?
My butt touching?
Your butt doesn't get to touch. Your,
was my butt touching last time?
No, but your chest wasn't either. So the accountability is right here, and nothing below your hips, nothing down there gets to touch. Let's go. Number four. Come on. One. Get that butt in the air. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. It's not touching. Eight. Wait, that was seven. Sorry, you gotta give me one more. Okay, this was you. I said, make your chest touch, and you went, here. That's your belly. Okay, what happens as soon as I go from here to here? Oh, it's harder. One, two, okay? These little manipulations, even though everything's already hard, so in your brain you might be going, David's already hard. Yes, it is, but why not be hard and end up with the muscle we want rather than be hard and not? Deal? All right, let's go.
How many?
Three sets left. Who's the man? Who's the man, Alan?
Me.
One, yes. Two, perfect. Three, four, five, six, come on. Seven, show me some. Eight, that's passion. Now, you're watching this. These sets get harder. Okay, it's the same amount of weight. Whoa, it's the same amount of weight. Check it out, it's the same amount of weight. Yet it's harder. He's got 16 left. These last 16 are gonna be much harder than the first 16. Mentally, you'd better be here. You'd better recheck why you came, why you sat in the car to go train with your trainer or drove to the gym that day. You get an hour into a hardcore workout and you're actually training the muscle groups intended, well, they're gonna be worn out. Okay, this isn't a half an arm day, a half a back day, a half a everything day. This is a, let's annihilate every muscle group and move on. Let's go. Think about why you came here. One, two, three, fighting. Four, second wind. Five, come on. Six, I will not give up. Seven, mess with me, I dare you. Eight. Yeah. You know, you said something earlier about people less mess with you less if the way they see you look or whatever. And that's somewhat true. And then you also have the guy sees a built guy over there, and he's going to mess with him just because you're built. But either way around, I got my uncle gets out of a car one time. I'm like 17 years old. I'm just a punk. And he pulls a little bit too far out in a stop sign, right? This guy comes wheeling around, slams on his brakes. He's with his girlfriend. He's going to be a badass. He gets out of his car. My uncle's, he's a banker, right? But he's an old bodybuilder. Not old, he's like, at the time he was probably 40, had a bad boy mustache, and he's just wearing the old 80s tank top so he can see most of his body. He's wearing a string. He looks over at me and he says, guess who wants to talk? Guess you should get out. Like, totally not showing off at all, right? And I'm just going, and I've been in 10 fist fights that week, but this is my uncle, okay? So I'm just going, what are you gonna do? Oh my God, what's gonna happen right now? My uncle gets out of the car, opens the door, takes three steps this way. Dude's girlfriend starts screaming at him, bloody murder. Get in the car, get in the car. Guy looks at my uncle, gets right back in the car and drives away. I have never forgot that moment the rest of my life. Training in here can keep you out of trouble. Let's go. Stay inspired. Now this last set is of eight. You're gonna do as many as you can. One, two, as many as you can. Three, four, what's my potential? Five, six, seven, eight, what's my potential? Nine, how bad do you want it? 10, we will fight. 11, 12, don't you give up. 13, only you know if you're trying. 14, I don't care how much noise you know. How hard are you trying right now? Yes, come on. Now hold plank, hold it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, you fight me, you son of a. 3, 2, 1, good job. Solid. Solid effort.
50.
What did we get? What did we get? Say it again.
150.
150. 150. 150 means you tried. 150 means you care. 150 means you used half of the things that I just was spitting into this guy's ear. 150 means you want a chest. Good job, buddy. Oh! Yeah. Okay? You watch this thing. You watch yourself doing it, and you duplicate it. Now, this is no lie. This footage right here says you did it. You cannot puss out after this. Okay? When you're home alone and you're training, be inspired. Remember, God help you remember that you can do it. That's half the, last night, I swear to God, okay, this happened to me, it was 2 nights ago. I don't mess around with the heavyweights very often. I'm big into strict form, you know, we go over all this stuff. But the other day I went, okay, KImmerle, you preach chaos, you preach confusing the muscles, you preach doing something that you don't always do. So what did I do? I looked at those 120s. I swear I must have looked at them for 5 minutes. I'm sitting in the gym, I'm looking around going, what happens if I don't lift them and everybody expects me in here to be Mr. Strong, Johnny Hollywood guy? What happens if I can't get them above my head? No, that's not how we think. I looked at those, and this is 5 minutes of process, me looking at these weights. And I finally just went, all right. I picked them up and hit a personal record. I haven't touched 120s in 6 months. Personal record, okay? I think I got them 13, 14 times. It's not a lot, but it was perfect form in my defense. And the empowerment of that, I had to, going back to where I was just screaming, is I literally laid back on the bench and went, I can do this. I'm not usually an affirmation guy. Like, I use a lot of negatives in the gym. Like, I'm gonna kick my own butt, or I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. This was a positive affirmation. I can do this. I just knew in my mind that I could do it, but I swear to God in my heart, I didn't know. That's backwards. Your heart says you can, and your mind tells you no. Sometimes you gotta flip it around. You gotta know the difference. That'll make sense to all you when you get to a level that you're trying beyond the status quo, beyond the guy sitting next to you that doesn't sweat at the gym either, okay? Ready for the next muscle group? All right, okay. Okay, right now, we're finishing up the very last set. This gentleman has 5 minutes. What do we do in 5 minutes? Pick a muscle group.
Triceps.
Put me on the spot. Triceps. I like it. Okay, we have 5 minutes to do triceps. Follow me, watch this. Here you go. Over your head, you're gonna notice your hat is backwards, so I'm gonna flip it around on you. Lift that weight from your head. Now, pop that above your head. One, two, three, four. This is too heavy for you. Full extension.
It's just too heavy.
Yep.
Today.
Yeah, we have been working out for an hour. One, two, three, four, five. Show me the definition of straight arms. Six, seven, eight. Keep going. Nine. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, halfway there, 16, 17, do not hit your head with the dumbbell, 18, 19, 20, come on, 21, 22, what is this? 23, what are we doing now? Hey, wait. Where are we mentally?
Not here.
Okay, let's get here.
Okay.
We want triceps. Let's go. Straighten the arms. Ah, come on! Okay, this is you jumping up and down. I don't care how bad it hurts. Okay, give me three perfect ones. One, two, three. Good job. Beautiful. Beautiful. How bad did that hurt? That probably felt like the 2 pound dumbbells I had to put over my head this morning for 4 minutes straight. It felt like eternity. Oh, that's 25 pounds. Okay, but you know what? It gets really, really heavy. Here and here, here and here. Oh.
All right, we're good? Finished?
No, we're not done. We got 5 minutes. You said, hey, KImmerle, I want triceps in 5 minutes. Well, you do 5 sets of 30.
How many did you just do?
You just did 30. I mean, you probably did 15 of them beautiful.
How many more do I
as many as you can in 5 minutes. Big arms never came in 5 minutes, but I'll tell you what, you can get a workout in 5 minutes that will help you get big arms. Let's go. Because I'm a badass and I know it. Because I'm going to go to the marquee pool party and I'm going to have the best party there next year. If it's for Vegas, once again, okay, think about why you're here. Think about something that makes you mad. Think about your potential. Think about all those years of training. And right now you're going to demand something different of you. You're absolutely not going to settle for the status quo. For the last 20 years of training and going to the gym, and I'm definitely not going to do any more damn quarter reps. Unless they're on purpose. Those are quarter reps. Okay, rest. Now, no, wait, hold it right here. Now, we just went to our pain threshold, right? It's all we can take, it's all we can take, it's all we can take. Oh, and it is. He did it. 10, 5, 4, 3, 2. See that? We exhaled, we found ourselves, and we go again. It's literally when you get your brain back. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, drop it, 10, 10, 9, no, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, I could have just said do 100 straight, 2, 1, pick it up. You've gathered yourself mentally. Why are we here? Why are we here? Come on, make yourself mad, pissed off. I cannot live another day like this. I will not, I refuse to walk out of here disappointed in myself again, knowing I had anything left. I refuse. 10, 9, 8, we're not messing around. 6, 5, 4, look at that chest. 3, it's hanging down below the abs. 1. 1, 2, beautiful. 3, 4, right here. 5, I want arms. 6, I want arms so bad. 7. 8, 9, 10. I don't care if vanity is your reason. It shouldn't be a reason, but if it is, you have a reason. As long as that puts fire in your gullet and you want to come in here and rip apart muscle tissue and let it scar over and let it get bigger and enjoy the health benefits of that, let vanity be your reason, okay?
I think we have 10 more left.
You got 10 more left? Yeah? He says, I think I got 10 more left. I better get 30 out of him. Come on, let's go. This is the fun part. 1, first 100 reps didn't matter. 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, rest for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, gather my mind. 4, shake it out. 5, rip the head off a bear. 6, let's go. Come on, 1. 2, 3, I would not mess with you. 4, 5, 6, 7, I dare you to mess with me. 8, 10, good job. 10, 9, 8, 7, dare you to mess with me. 6, come on. 5, 4, yeah. 3, 2, let's see that anger face. 1, 1, 2, get those arms down. 3, 4, all the way down. 5, 6, all the way down. 7, 8, 9, 10.
I gotta go.
Yes, he's gotta go. Okay, he's gotta pay the meter. He's already paid it twice. No, our training's done.
I just don't wanna do anymore.
You don't wanna do anymore? Wait, come over here and look in this camera. You're talking to you, man. You tell me what you think right now. Tell yourself to go get some. Please, will it out of yourself. Alan, please.
I can do more. I can do more.
And you can do more every single time. You know why? Because if you did as much as you could do the previous time, your body's gonna expect it, and it will learn from that, and it doesn't like that. So what does it do? It tries to compensate and allow you to basically do more the next time. Because it doesn't ever wanna do as much as it can. If that's as much as it can, it's gonna make sure that as much as it can is more the next time, because it never wants to max out. It's your nervous system. It doesn't want you to max out, okay?
Thanks.
Good job, right, buddy.
Listen, I'll see you tomorrow evening, but I'll see you at the Grand Central. Thanks for your help.
Take care, buddy. Hey, no tickets in Hollywood. Really proud of that guy. Okay, I am. This is inspiring stuff for me. People say, Dave, why don't you just take a lot of clients? Why don't you you know, you make okay money an hour. What's up with that? What's this with the .com and all this nonsense? Why are you doing that? You can make good money a day. And I'll admit, this .com is way harder work. I do it because I get disheartened. I'll be honest. I have a hard part compartmentalizing. Negative energy, case of pussitis, for lack of better words, ladies, excuse me. It's contagious, and I can't take it, and I'll notice myself. I go to the gym over here, I got a good buddy. He's kind of a big deal. And I'll tell you what, that kid brings me down. I try to train with him, and he doesn't want to go. Go, rip that up, Bear. Oh my God, I don't want to hear how sore you are. I want to hear how awesome it is that you feel that bad. If you can walk, you should be mad at yourself. From my perception, you're trying to be number one in the world, okay? This gentleman, he's not trying to be number one in the world. He's trying to reach his potential. He's trying to look good. It's a vanity thing. But I don't train as many guys, because if they don't give me what he just had, even if it's not a lot, even if it's a 20-pound weight, I don't care what it is, if it's as much as he can give, okay? It's always that. It's always as much as you can do. And if he does that, that's contagious. So you see, my energy's up. Hell, I'm more excited than I was when I started this thing. It's further in the day. I should be more tired. But I'm actually inspired, and I'm empowered, and I feel good. And to me, it's a neat experience to be around these people. Like watching The Biggest Loser and these guys trying to lose weight when I'm running on the treadmill. I really want to run harder. So if you got anything out of this video, if you understand a word of what happened, the weights don't matter. Even the equations don't matter. Your pain threshold, and you giving it everything you have, and you setting down, stopping, regathering your mind mentally and going, okay, I can do more. Can I do more? Am I going to get injured, or did I do enough? If you've been through that process and you gave it everything you had, potential, that's a quality workout. See you guys next time. Dave KImmerle.